Many people use OneDrive to store files, but they still send it as attachment rather than a link. Why? They have some concern or confusion. They're thinking, if I send a link, it's one file, multiple people, who changed what? How will I know? And that's the question we are going to answer in this video. I have three files, Word, Excel, PowerPoint. I've created the files already. I've shared the files with assistant and sales, two people. They have already made changes to it. But now I have opened the files and I want to know who changed what and when. Let's start with Word. In this document, I have already enabled track changes. You know how track changes works. Whoever changes something, it's shown there in different color. And when you take your cursor there, it will show you the date timestamp and person name as well. The problem comes when I have shared the file as a link, but I did not enable track changes for whatever reason. Now, how do I know who changed what? Go to that file name, open the drop down. You will see version history. It will show you multiple versions depending on how much editing has happened. You can go to a particular version. It's a read only copy. The show edits option is on by default. It shows you the number of edits, and using these arrows, you can navigate one by one. You click on the arrow to move to the next one. This is an older version. It compared this document with the current version, the latest version, and retrospectively added track changes to it. Now, in either case, you want to see all of them together. No problem. You can go to the tracking menu and choose reviewing pane. Now it shows me a list of all changes. And when I click on a particular change, it will scroll it into view. One word of caution with this approach. Sometimes it does not identify the correct person who changed it, although tracking will still be done. Let's do a similar thing in Excel. Go to the review tab. You will see show changes button. It will open a separate pane. It will show changes at workbook level or a range level. Or I can right click on a particular cell and say show changes only to this cell. As you have seen in Word, there are versions being created automatically depending upon the volume of editing. There is a show edits button. When I click on a particular version, it shows you the edits and you can move between edits. Unlike Word, you will not see the name of the person. That's a lacuna. Another deficiency is it does not show changes which are made to charts and shapes, does not show pivot table operations, formatting changes, hiding of cells and ranges of filtering, and deleted location. If you really want comprehensive comparison, use Inquire Compare Spreadsheet option. You can have a look at this video to understand how to use it. Next, let's see what happens in PowerPoint. Slides which have undergone change, the thumbnail views will see blue dots like this. If you hover there, it'll tell you slide has undergone changes. When you click there, it'll show you objects which have changed, and they are indicated with a blue border. If you hover on each one of them, it'll tell you who did it and when they did it. Notice that these are transient changes. Changes I have already reviewed are no longer available once you move away from the slide. Another option we have is to go to version history. Look at the past versions. You will see the current state at that point of time. You will not see anything equivalent of track changes or show changes. You'll have to save this as a file and then compare the files. I do have a separate video on how to do comparison in PowerPoint. For this to work, you need to have either browser version of Word, Excel, PowerPoint, or you need to have the Microsoft 365 version of Office. Desktop versions of Office like Office 16, 19 or 2021 will not give you all these features. Another thought is, I don't have Microsoft files. I have CorelDRAW files. I have Photoshop files, AutoCAD files. In those cases, you have to go to the individual app and check, does it have any features which give you equivalent of track changes? Now, I'm sure you're more confident about sharing files as links instead of attachments. Before you go, have a look at these two popular videos about OneDrive best practices. So that's it for now. See you next time. Take care.